time that I could think of with Christina when I really realized that she was really in love with this guy, Christopher. Christina came to visit me in Kansas City for Valentine's Day a couple of years ago. We went to a musical, we had dinner. Christopher said that she could stay the night with me. But by the end of the night, Christina was not having a very pleasant time. And I asked her what was wrong, and she said she couldn't bear to spend Valentine's Day without Christopher. And she drove all the way home in the middle of the night to stay next to him. And that's when I knew they were in love, and I accepted it. Fast forward a year and a half, he finally proposed. And here we are celebrating their beautiful wedding. Christina and Kris, here's to you and your many adventures together. I hope they're always exciting.
And those of you who know me know I'm a man of few words, so. Congrats, Kris. All I want to say is congratulations, you two. You guys make a great couple. And everybody here, I think, can tell that you guys are so much in love. So congratulations. Thank you.
I'm Michael, Kris is your brother. Congratulations.
As the youngest sibling, it was like having six parents growing up. Kris always found a way to make me feel like I mattered. She beat me to the chaos and excitement. That comes with a big family. Christina, I hope you know, me and Maggie will always look for you guys for a prize. And Christopher, I hope you know that you're marrying an amazing woman. And she's a wonderful person, and I hope you know you guys have a lifetime of happiness together. But she's a parson, so you know what that means.
Wait, buddy.
My only advice for you is to treat her like a princess. Life should be really easy. Say hi to her, you guys, and she's gonna like it too.
Labor Day 2015, I get a call from Christina, and this call from Christina is not a good call. She tells me that Christopher's been involved in a jet ski accident, that he's on a respirator, they had to life watch him, and he's on a respirator in a hospital. He can't speak, he's unconscious, and in her voice, I heard the fear and I heard the worry. No girl her age, anybody's age, should have to tell a mother that type of stuff. But she was brave. These two right here did an awesome job with this daughter. I can't thank them enough for that. Christina was there. She calmed us. She updated us. And Christopher, oh my goodness, my guy that likes to talk, he could not talk. He was... Oh, I hope it's not for me to miss people. He was pissed off. He was fiery mad. You can see it in his eyes that are green. They were fiery green and good to check out every good to them. But Christina humored him. She calmed him. And she soothed him all throughout that. We were there. Mama was there. Papa was there. Hell was there, Christina. He's mine. It's bad. She never left his side. Thank you guys. I appreciate your tolerance for my yapping, but I am so proud and so happy to be a part of this family, and she makes me proud.
it applies to everyone. So there's a common thing that's found in most marriages that are long lasting. And you have to remember that you're both unique to you, that you can't compare yourself to everybody else. You're yourself. Competition is only going to make you happy and beautiful. Be each other's best friend. I'm not saying Kris is going to be happy to go to every Disney musical. Together in activities and free time around each other. You're no longer two single units, but one life partner.
Take me on a date. I just you for having time tonight, guys. We had a good time. We do have one last request to play this song as we're going out.
Yeah.